The preface from Sex, Dimensions Beyond the New. This book will finish by end of this week, probably by Saturday it will finish. Preface, Sex, Dimensions Beyond the Known. Man is a universe within an outer universe. Just like the body of the universe, the human body is composed of cells. These cells are interconnected by an electromagnetic force. This force works through electrolytes present in each cell. Individual human consciousness is a byproduct of ego and mind. All states of pain, pleasure exist because of this ego-mind combination. It is because of this eternal pair of ego and mind that we have innumerable desires. Man requires tremendous energy to fulfill these desires. Unfulfilled desires cause illness and pain. These require method to cure the disease and the pains. When you are young, full of energy and strength, you can repress sexual desires. It is normal. There is tremendous energy within. And you can pour your entire energy into suppression. However, after 42, you will become weak. You have entered another cycle of your sexual energy. Slowly and slowly, every day you will become weaker. You will become weak, but the repressed sexual desire that have been accumulated for years will be very strong. The energy that is repressing it will be weaker, but the energy that is repressed and accumulated over the years will become stronger day by day. The real problem starts after 42. People do not know at all. They do not know the ways of energy. They do not know how this existential bioenergy works. They have not explored this energy and its functioning meditatively. In the process, over the period of time, the repressor person will become weak, but all that is repressed never becomes weak. The repressed goes on accumulating and ultimately reaches the state of explosion. And when the repression begins to explode, you have no control over it. The repressions also come because of your taboos, religious upbringing, and lack of understanding of the movement of bioenergy properly. This is what has happened to the vast humanity. Husbands and more so wives go on washing their dirty linens in public after the age of 42. And what Swiss psychoanalyst Carl Gustav Jung has said just before dying, that on the basis of being a physician is quite relevant about man. I can say that all the patients who came to me after the age of 42, basically their illness was because of the lack of religion. It is quite surprising. But if somehow we can give them some kind of religion, then they will become healthy. Man is seven-step spiritual ladder. These seven steps are your chakras or psycho-spiritual centers. Your religions, cultures and societies do not want you to get a stronghold of the first step and speak of a spiritual journey. Sex energy is stored at the base center or Mooladhara. Ganpati Ganesh is the presiding deity at this center. If you are intelligent, only then you can see the whole conspiracy of religions. If you are intelligent, only then you can see the whole conspiracy of religions. Sufis rarely initiate a person who is not married. Marriage helps to sublimate the volatile nature of this energy. And if one has understood the existential energy, the transformation becomes possible. One day you are born as the interaction between ovum and sperm. Sperm represents the masculine energy and ovum represents the feminine energy. The birth always happens as the interaction between these two aspects of the cosmic energy. And then your life of conflict and duality continues. And one day suddenly the life energy is released once again from the sex center into the unknown oblivion. Death happens. One day you are born out of sexual interaction, and again one day you are taken to death through the same center without any flowering of your being. Very rarely the journey of transcendence beyond sex begins in an individual. Through sex you were born one day, through sex center one day you disappear. And by understanding the flow of this existential bioenergy, one day you are reborn. The flowering of the being begins. Going through the sexual intercourse meditatively, when masculine and feminine energies move in harmony and rhythm, you get the first glimpse of Satori, the orgasmic experience of the dissolution of the two energies. During the moments of sexual orgasm, when the two energies merge into one another, the couple experience the fleeting glimpse of the state beyond time and space. In that orgasm, you experience timelessness and you disappear in the unknown. It is out of such experience of inner oneness that Sri Vatsayana, Vatsayana's classic treatise on Kama Sutra emerge as the sutras of Kama. The principles and the techniques for the transformation of this existential bioenergy. And when this energy is transformed, the flowering of consciousness as enlightenment takes place. Out of this understanding, Tilopa's Mahamudra, the songs of Saraha, and the supreme understanding of Tantra emerged. And today, once again, the enlightened awareness, the light of the being, overflows as sex beyond the dimensions, beyond the known. As today, once again, the enlightened awareness, the light of the being, overflows, sex, dimension, beyond the globe. This ultimately becomes the cosmic orgasmic experience of oneness and dissolution, and then one day explodes as enlightenment. Sex is the dimension of the spirituality beyond the realm of the globe. Sex is the most spontaneous and natural energy, mocked, disfigured, blamed and continuously criticized by the society, power and the religious custodians. To understand sex, you have to go to the dimensions beyond the living. Breathing and meditation is the vehicle to take you to that unknown and unknowable realm. Whenever sex is understood, this indomitable energy will transform, and in the process life will become a marvelous journey of the spirit. However, in the absence life will remain a mystery. All is too little that the world can give, because its power and knowledge are the gifts of time. These cannot Fill the spirit's sacred thirst. The world and its affairs cannot bring into life's closed room the immortals, air, and fill the finite and with the infinite. All that denies this must be torn out and slain and crushed with many longings, for whose sake we lose the one for whom our lives were made. Sex is the manifestation of the existential bioenergy at the lowest rung. At the lowest rung, the energy represents the earth element. Like earth, the other elemental elements, water and fire, are also relevant. It is only when these three elements are saturated, the journey reaches the realm of emotions. The lower has to be sanctified, only then the energy gives rise to the positive elements. And finally, the energy connects to the sky element. When the earth and the sky elements are merged into one another, love is born. Love is the ultimate flowering of this existential energy. First, love gives you unity in your innermost core. Then you are no more a body, no more a mind, no more a soul. You are beyond. You are simply one, unnamed, undefined, unclassified. No more determinate, definable, no more comprehensible. A mystery, a joy, a surprise, jubilation, and a great celebration, a being alone. The soul's experiment of joy and grief, and thought and impulse, lighting the blind air, venture on the roads of circumstance. Through inner movement and external scenes traveling to self, across the forms of things into creation's center, he had come. The spirit wandering from the state to state finds here the silence of its starting point in the formless force and still fixity. This present book is an effort to bring clarity and insights into this specific topic on which ancient sages like Vatsyayana has created classes. Ajanta and Ellora caves were created. Even these have not been understood by the baser mind, and these sculptures were mocked and criticized as pornography, even by men like Gandhi. Human mind is quite ready to turn sex into pornography very easily, and thus keeps man from understanding this excess. This book is the beginning of the series in the process of human transformation and a deeper understanding of sex and spirituality, so that man can evolve to understand the subtlety of the subject.